children. Today we are going to take the second lesson from your history book, Growth of Nationalism. Children, as you have already read in the previous lesson that 1857, the first war of independence was fought, but it was a complete failure because the soldiers took the local problem. That problem they had taken was not a national wide. Now children, though it was a failure, but historians feel that it can be considered the first war of independence because that gave rise to the feeling of nationalism among the people of India. Now what does the word nationalism means? Nationalism refers to the feeling of oneness and common consciousness that emerges when people living in common territory share the same historical, political, and cultural background, have the same language, cultural values, and consider themselves as one nation. Means the people living in the same boundaries, same place, have a feeling of oneness among themselves. Now, India has a long history, children. You all know that India has not been a one nation. It has always been divided into small territories which was ruled by different kings. As there were many kingdoms, there was lack of feeling of nationalism among these people. Now there were many factors which contributed to the growth of nationalism in India, and some of them are economic exploitation. Now in your previous lesson also, children, you have read that how Indian farmers, artisans, common people were exploited by the Britishers. This led the common people to stand opposite to British rule. Policies which were made by Britishers was never for the welfare of the Indian people, but it was always for the welfare of the British. Now the peasants of India, they were totally ruined by the policies which was made by Britishers. British East India Company used to force the farmers to grow the crop that they wanted, means the raw material that they needed for their industry. They wanted the farmers to grow only that, and they destroyed the handicraft and industries because the raw material was taken from India to England was without paying any duty. The finished good was brought to Indian market, that also was free of duty. Now this destroyed the market of Indian people, Indian artisans. Handicraft market was destroyed totally by the Britishers. Now the second cause was the working class. Now because of the growth of industries gave birth to new social class in India, and that class was known as working class. They were exploited by the factory owners because the factory owners forced them to work hard for longer period of time, but these people were given very low wages. Then educated Indians were also looking forward to British to get a good jobs. But the only job available to Indians, educated Indians, were government service, which was there was heavy competitions among the people, and they had to work very hard and they have to face a lot of competition to achieve high rank. But though they expected the high rank, promotion was very bleak. They were never given high position. All the higher post was occupied by the Europeans. Now people thought that British were working for the development of India, but later when the time went on, they found all the British policies were keeping Indian economic backward, because all the facility was given to Europeans and all the profit which they made was taken to England. Nothing was done for the benefit of Indian society. These policies became the major barrier to Indian economic social and cultural and political development. Some repressive policies of British that led to the growth of nationalism movement were, now children, you must have remembered that in the previous lesson I had told you about the proclamation of the Queen, about Queen Victoria as the Empress of India. In 1877, Grand Darbar was organized at Allahabad to proclaim Queen Victoria as the Empress of India. Now, this was the time when Bengal was facing a severe famine. Children, at this time, the people of Bengal were dying of hunger, poverty. Still, the British government spent lakh of rupees to celebrate this occasion of proclaiming Queen Victoria as the Empress of India. Children, further, the British introduced many acts to suppress the Indian nationalism, and the most important was Vernacular Press Act of 1878 and Indian Arms Act of 1878. Both were against the Indian people. Now, in Vernacular Press Act, all the Indian press except of the English press, they were not allowed to print anything which was against the British, because according to the British, through this paper, the leaders of India, freedom leaders, they were arousing the feeling of nationalism among the Indian people. Now, the second act was Indian Arms Act. It was considered as criminal act for the Indians to carry the weapons. They were not allowed to carry any kind of weapon, and if any Indian was found with a weapon, they were arrested and they were put to jail. And both the policies were meant only for Indians but not the English people. Now children, the maximum age of Indian civil service, previously it was 21 years, but later it was reduced to 19 years. Now children, the examination age was reduced to 19 years, and thus it was very difficult for Indian people to compete or to sit in the examination and pass the examination, because 19 years was a very low age for the Indians to compete in any competitive exams. Now, impact duty on British goods were removed, and this proved harmful for the Indian industries, because now British was not paying any duty for any industry. They were free to import or export goods. Now, there were many socio-religious reform movement took place in India. These social reforms were taken up by some educated Indian people, learning leaders, learned people, who wanted to make change in the society of India, because these people felt that until and unless the Indian are educated, until and unless they don't have the old thinking, they leave their old thinking, they will not come forward, they cannot achieve independence. So children, these leaders, they did a lot of work to remove the ill or evil things from the Indian society and make the Indian people educated. Now, this social religious reform movement teaching every segment of Indian society was born. They work for, and these societies, they work for the abolition of caste system, child marriage, then dowry system and parda system. Now, some of the prominent reforms were, the movement, these reforms were made by the people. Now, for this reform, they had formed a society, Samaj. Now, some major Samaj was Brahmo Samaj, which was founded by Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Arya Samaj by Swami Dayanand Saraswati, Ramakrishna Mission by Swami Vivekanand, Satya Sodhak Samaj by Jyotiba Phule. Now children, I have given you the name of the reformers and the society which was formed by them. You will read the about the society, what were the objectives from your book. Now children, the role of press at the time of nationalism, this was very important. The press played a very important role at this time. Large number of newspapers started in the later half of the 19th century. Now some of the major newspaper which was published at this time was Amrit Bajar Patrika, the Bengali, the Tribune, the Pioneer, the Times of India, the Hindu, the Statesman in English. These press played a significant role in the speak of nationalism. They worked hard, and these newspapers, they were published in the local language so that the common people also can read the paper and can